What's up, everybody, and welcome back to the Daily Hero, especially your comic movie, TV, video game, nerdy news, goodness here on the internet. I hope you had a really fun holiday. Hope you watched some cool movies. I'm Sean Barry, and here is today's top stories. Well, the good news is Wonder Woman 1984 came out. And a lot of people saw it. It made $16.7 million at the box office in theaters over the weekend. That's how good of a big debut this is. This is the biggest debut any film's had basically this year. That's an incredible feat for a movie during the time of COVID pandemic. And the fact it only came out in 2,100 theaters, which is about half of what it usually would. $16.7 million. And on top of that, HBO said nearly half of its viewership watched Wonder Woman 1984 on the first day it came out, which is roughly about 15 million people. So this show, it's roughly translate that, the opening would have been about $85-90 million if it came out in traditional times. And we could also assume it probably would have made probably a little more because people would just have seen it normally during the summer as you're supposed to. So this movie would have been a big hit, at least for an opening weekend. Now here comes the bad news. The bad news is Wonder Woman 1984, people fucking hated it. They did not like this thing. It lost its certified fresh rating on Rotten Tomatoes, which very rarely happens. It got a B cinema score, which you don't know is really, really bad, even though it's just a B. Most films average in the A- range, so that's not doing good. Most fans are pretty upset with how Chris Pine came back and the overall plot and action and direction of the film in general. Like, I include myself in that. I thought it had one of the most ridiculous MacGuffins of any superhero film. I feel like it was meandering, too overstuffed. The humor did not work at all because they gave it all away in the trailers. So I don't know about you guys, I thought Wonder Woman 1984 was a pretty big disappointment and not a very good movie. But Warner Brothers was so happy with the result of this weekend that they had to be fast-tracking Wonder Woman 3 with Gal Gadot and Patty Jenkins to return. Personally, I think it's time they changed hands at director after seeing this latest outing. Plus, Patty Jenkins has a big slate coming up and she's doing a new Cleopatra film and doing Rogue Squadron for Disney. So, we shall see. What did you guys think about Wonder Woman 1984? Did you hate it? Did you love it? Do you think it should be deleted from the archives of history? Did you buy a gemstone and wish upon it? God, the movie's dumb. Check out the Here Never podcast where we talk more in depth about it, guys. Other than that, let me know what you think down below. I, like many of you, probably watched Wonder Woman 1984 on HBO Max in my living room, on my TV, in my house, as opposed to risking my life and going to a movie theater this time of the crisis. And because of that, most films in the future are probably going to come out in streaming services first. It's just the future of the industry and the way it's going to go. And it's recently revealed that Warner Brothers has decided that they're going to start developing movies specifically for HBO Max of the DC variety. But they're going to do it with smaller characters at first, ones that they deem quote-unquote riskier at the box office. Two examples, Walter Hamada, the CEO of DC, included were Batgirl and Static Shock, two properties people have longed to see. So this is an interesting take on how the entire industry is going to keep going. As we know, the Suicide Squad next year will come out on HBO Max, making it the second film to debut on the streaming service that is was intended for theaters, but we'll still see. The problem is, like most Netflix stream movies, is that they're getting way smaller budgets because they can't recoup their money at the box office, which is the overall risk and thing of it. So that's why a lot of films on Netflix look terrible, the sound and production design are bad, because they aren't able to spend that extra mile to make films as glorious as we like them. You know, like it or not, you know, a big budget film has its perks, because you can really see the mastery of the craft at hand. Like Avengers Endgame, can you imagine if they cut that budget in half, how much that would have sucked? But that's just my opinion. Guys, let me know what you think down below. Ever since it was announced that Zack Snyder gets to complete his Justice League vision with the Snyder Cut coming out on HBO Max this coming March, allegedly, many of his fanboys have thought that, oh, this is just the beginning. He's going to be able to make Justice League 2 and complete the whole vision in its entirety and get everybody back. And, well, I'm here to tell you that that's just not going to happen. As most of the execs at Warner Bros. Look at this as a dead end, as they define it, as a storytelling cul-de-sac. Is it one way and that's where it ends? Because this film will not be profitable for them in any capacity. Plus, most people are pretty done with working with Zack Snyder and the future as a whole. The DCEU is moving in a completely different direction with different storytelling and different actors, as Patty Jenkins and Gal Gadot said Wonder Woman 3 will be their last. Ben Affleck is done with the entire Batman thing after the Flashpoint film. Plus, on top of that, Ray Fisher doesn't seem like he's inclined to ever come back as Cyborg. And, you know, Jason Momoa is just a bad actor, so you have a lot of that going against you in terms of what the future of the DCEU is going to hold. It's probably on television, realistically, if I were to take a solid guess. Because only Marvel can apparently really do the whole cinematic universe thing, where all the actors are down to do 20 movies and, you know, keep appearing in things and have one continuous narrative thread that works out really well. It's just the way things turned out. I'm a DC fanboy myself, and it sucks that we never got our chance to get an awesome Darkseid vs. Superman moments, or, you know, like a Blackest Night event, or an Infinite Crisis, or any of the cool shit that we've been reading about for years. But that's life. That's all the news I got for you guys. Please check out this, like this video, share, subscribe, tell your friends, yada yada yada. You get the point. Well, we're doing low. It's the new year. New year, new Hero Network, and Hero Network TV. Hero Network TV on all social media platforms, the podcast, the Patreon, the works. Follow me personally at Big Bear 63 on Instagram. Follow me at Big Bear Comedy on TikTok. And then I'll see you tomorrow.